Welcome, I'm Elizabeth Harper. I'm here with this month's crystal messages. I have a bag of crystals. In a moment, I'm going to pop my hand into the bag and take out one of the crystals that has an influence over all of us for the month ahead. I'll read that crystal and the energy of the crystal. Then I'll invite you to select crystal one, two, or three, a personal message for yourself. You can move your cursor along to your particular message. Also, what I'd love you to do is see if you can intuit what the color of the crystal is, maybe what the crystal is too, before I take it out of the bag. All right, you ready? Okay, so let's see what we have in here. The bottom of the bag. This is more crystal. All right, this is a piece of jasper. This is red jasper. Look, this is a heart. It's a heart shape. Jasper is a grounding stone because, it's red. The red stones can often be grounding stones. This has this vibration of, excuse me, of giving you courage. It's in your blood. There's this sense of being strong. There's this feeling of course, we're moving away from the Mars energy, aren't we? There's that shift in Mars. And I'm feeling like this is coming up with Mars, the red planet, the red energy. I feel like it's very much about owning who you are and really getting a sense of where you belong. That's what it feels like with this. The heart, especially. Where does my heart belong? Which country does my heart belong in? Which town does my heart belong in? Which relationship does my heart belong in? Which job does my heart belong in? I feel like this month you're going to be asking those questions of where does my heart belong? And that Mars vibration, I just feel like it's coming up quite strongly with this particular stone with the heart. There's a sense of movement forward, action, movement forward. Let's take that next step. Okay, this is where I belong. I'm going to move forward towards it. I feel like, you know, because it's red jasper, there's a sense of safety. There's a sense of groundedness. There's a sense of security that's coming in here. So you're going to feel safe enough to take that next step, safe enough to say, this isn't right for me. I'm moving on. It's all about where your heart is. That's the sense of it for this month. All right. Now, for you, for your personal stone, remember, intuit, tune in. Crystal one, two, or three, which one feels right for you, and then move along to your crystal. All right, number one, let's see what you have. Let's see if you can intuit what the color is. Colors. This is a piece of tiger's eye. It's golden tiger's eye. Isn't that gorgeous? Really looks like a tiger. Tiger's skin, fur, hair. Now, with this piece of tiger's eye, there is... it's heaven and earth. There is the sun, that vibration of the sun, and that vibration of the earth that comes into it because of the golden energy of the sun. I'm looking around because the sun's coming into my room. And the brown of the earth. So this is about bringing in the light into your life. Now, when you look at this, of course, there are lots of different stripes to it. So it's being on the earth, and then it's calling on the light. So what would that be? It's a manifestation vibration. So you're calling in the light into the earth plane, and you're visualizing, this is what I want. This is what I want to create. This is who I want to be. Again, with that number one, with the heart, you know, this is who I want to be. This is the path I want to take. This is the relationship I need at this moment. This is an amazing manifestation vibration. It's also very protective. So there's almost an aspect of it that says, you know, if this isn't really productive for you, or if this isn't in your best interest, then even though you're asking for it to manifest, it may well not manifest at this moment. So there's a sense of protection that comes in with this. Doesn't mean that you're not going to get what you most want, what you most desire. But sometimes we ask for things and they're not necessarily in our best interests. So there's a sense of protection that comes in with this as well. I'm also getting this sense of a friend, of a, it feels like a spirit energy that's coming in to support you. So it's not necessarily somebody on a physical plane, if that makes sense. There's more of a sense of a spiritual energy. And as I'm talking about this, my video light is changing all the time. So I always know that spirit's around when that happens. So I feel that there's probably a new guide that's coming into your energy field, or an angel, or a loved one from spirit that is right there letting you know that they're helping you, guiding you, supporting you, really cheering you on so that you can achieve the success that you most want at this moment. I'm feeling like there's something else with this. You know, when I look at it, it almost looks like a barcode. It's kind of interesting. And I feel that there's a reason for that. Let me see, what is it? It's not about shopping, but it's about, okay, it's about looking at your finances and counting up how much you have, how much you have to spend, how much you need to save, how much you can put here, how much you can put there. That's what's coming in with this. And I can see it now because it's very practical with the gold and the black. Gold may well be, okay, I can spend this. And the black is just, you need to save that. So there's a sense of finances right now, just looking at them and being mindful of where you're putting your cash, where you're putting your money, where you're putting your savings to. Okay, number two, let's see what you have. See if you can intuit what the crystal is. Oh, this is Labradorite. Labradorite. It has this beautiful sheen. Can you see that? The sheen on it. It's a grey stone with a spectrolite within it, so it shines. And it's a magical stone. It's a really magical stone. It links in with your, I'm seeing sparks around as I say that, links in with your psychic abilities, with your intuition, your skills, your gifts, etc. These are all expanding. Looks like you're very sensitive this month to energies coming in. This is a transformation stone as well, of course, because of course it changes color. So it's transformation. There's that energy of change, of shifts, of transforming from one way of being into a new way of being. I almost feel like, you know, when I'm feeling this stone and I'm tuning into what the kind of mass energy is, it feels almost like getting more strategic and getting more practical. You wouldn't think it, would you, with this kind of stone? But there's a sense of being more practical about what you need to do next. What's that path for you to take? And I have this sense of really being strategic about it and saying, no, this is not the right way for me to go, even though I felt that this was the place for me to take my next step, but this is what I wanted. I'm feeling like this is saying it's time for you to look at the bigger picture, to look into the future, to look at what you're doing now and how that's going to impact your future, how you're going to get from where you are now to that bigger picture of where you want to be, where you need to be. There's a huge energy again of transformation that comes in with this. And I feel that part of that is a mystical transformation. There's a sense of you recognizing that you need more spirituality in your life. You need more spiritual connections, more spiritual projects, hobbies, whatever that might be for you. And there's a sense of a deeper connection that's coming in for you over this next month. I'm also feeling as if, when you look at this, I don't know if you can see that, but it's like I'm looking at it with these lines and getting the sense of reading between the lines. I'm feeling as if people around you, that you're suddenly going to realize who's your friend and who's not. It's not saying who's your friend and who's not, it's just who are the people you can trust, who are the people you can rely upon, who are the people that really have your best interests in heart at heart. And I'm feeling that this month you're going to realize that. And you're going to realize it not just with friends, but with loved ones as well. And there may be a particular relationship that you've been in that you're now going to realize what that relationship truly means for you. Okay, number three, let's see what you have. Okay, this is a piece of black tourmaline. Now, this is kind of interesting. Did I put all the crystal back? I did, didn't I? We've had all kind of grounding stones. All the stones have been a little bit, on this level of connecting in with the earth, maybe connecting in with the heavens as well. And this is another grounding stone. This is highly protective. This black tourmaline, you put that black tourmaline and it creates a boundary around you, creates a space around you, creates protection around you. When I look at this, when I feel into it, I feel as if you're becoming stronger. There's a sense that you may have been a bit stressed. You may have felt like you were not getting very far in your life, in your work, in your relationships, that things have been kind of chugging along, maybe. But this is saying that the stress of that is lifting. And when I see the black, it's almost like a blackboard, and you're ready to write something new on the blackboard. You kind of wipe it off, and you're ready to create something new within that black. Black to me is highly creative because it has all the colors within it. White light has all the colors within it, and black pigment has all the colors within it. So when I look at this, it's saying you have everything you need, everything at your disposal. Whatever it is you are asking for, it's already there. You just need to kind of move things around and create it, if that makes sense. I feel that this is saying that your strength is you're getting stronger physically, mentally, emotionally, spiritually. There's a sense of physical strength that comes with this. When I feel it, it's like I want to sit up straight. And there's a feeling of maybe looking at your diet or looking at your health or looking at something that will support your strength and especially your bones. Feeling like your bones are going to get stronger as well. I feel like there's one last thing with this. I keep looking at it and feeling like it's about writing too. So you may find yourself over this month wanting to write things down, maybe write down plans, maybe write down visions, keeping a journal, that kind of thing. I feel like writing is going to be very important for you over this next month. And I feel that that writing is all about taking a next step, having a vision, creating something new for yourself. It's a wonderful energy, a fabulous adventure is waiting for you too. Okay, that's it for this month's crystal messages. I hope you enjoyed them. If you did, please give this video a thumbs up. Let me know in the comments below if the messages resonated and also if you intuited what the colors were in the crystals or maybe what the crystal was before I took it out of the bag. I would be honored if you would share this video with your friends. I'm sure they would love to have a crystal message this month. And of course, I will see you next month. Lots of crystal blessings to you. Bye, bye.